You may now know our guest from his highly successful radio show, Hollywood Unlocked, or his appearances, or as a cast member of MTV's Wild Night.
Mm-hmm. Now, I've been on his show, and now it's time for us to turn the tables and welcome Jason Lee to Sister Circle. Absolutely.
How are you? How are you? Good morning.
There were a lot of ands in the introduction, and he's there with this, and he's there with that, and
I'm trying to get like, y'all look expensive up here.
Yeah, you out here slashing and slaying the children.
Listen, it's early.
Yeah. So how is ATL treating you, Jason? I know once before you was not really rocking with the A.
No, it's not that I don't rock with the A. I mean, I just haven't had a good experience. But I did go out the other night with Nene, and she...
Okay.
I have a new affection for Atlanta.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. She showed you some good food, some good eats.
She took me to Swingin' Richard's, but it's too early.
Okay.
We'll talk about something else.
Yeah. Go down to the richer now. Very busy down to the richer. Gotta tell you. So have you found any of the Dominican places or anything here yet? Not yet?
I don't think y'all got Dominicans in Atlanta.
Why you? The people straight, they bone straight my homegirl's hair all the time.
Really? Well, maybe two or three of them. It ain't like New York up in Dykeman. Nah, but I mean, y'all got some beautiful black people out here. Our people are beautiful.
Yeah.
People think I'm Spanish for whatever reason, but I'm not. I'm black. I love my people, and I haven't seen no Dominicans, though, because that's what I'm looking for.
All right. Okay. All right. So talk to us about you.
Okay.
So how did your whole blog TV career start for you?
So I always knew that I wanted to be in media because I just feel like in order to inspire people or to have influence, you had to have a platform.
Yeah.
And then with the boom of social media, I decided that being around a lot of people who were in the public eye, you know, there are a lot of things being written about them that weren't true.
Yes.
So I wanted to unlock Hollywood. So Hollywood Unlocked.
Yeah, so what was your first big scoop or your favorite scoop?
I think my favorite scoop, besides all the folks from Married to Medicine that come on the show and act out, I think was you know, talking to Khalees about her relationship with Nas.
Oh, nice.
And her sharing in a very public way her private battles with domestic violence. That was a big one.
Right.
And I was in the Dominican Republic when that broke, by the way.
Wow. Well, listen, it's very challenging. I know you want to get information out there, and you just stated that you wanted to get the correct information out there. What level of integrity do you hold yourself to when the story has not even broken yet? Like, you know something that no one else knows.
Yeah, I mean, I only really have three rules. One, I don't, children are off limits.
Mm-hmm.
I don't out people. And private conversations I don't put out.
See, that's what I'm talking about.
Yes.
Well, a lot of people don't like you, Jason, sometimes because that, I mean, if everyone held themselves to your standard, I would love all the bloggers.
Well, I think, you know, what I learned is that when you have an opinion, people are going to take a side. I have an opinion about a lot of things, so people take a side. But there really was a point in my career where I was just like, you know, I can't really care what people think anymore. I just got to do what I feel is right. And sometimes people aren't going to like that, but that's cool.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. Well, you have a really great relationship with the very hot Cardi B.
Yeah.
So how did that relationship come to fruition, and how did it grow?
Yeah, I mean, I've always been a fan of Cardi before Love & Hip Hop, before music. I just thought she was a source of, you know, she's made you laugh on Instagram.
Right,
so I always
was
a fan. And then one day I was at Puff's house. He had a party. And she was coming over, and the party was shut down, but I made sure she was in and taking care of it, and then she just came on my show the next day, and from there, we just been rocking.
Wow.
Oh, yeah,
she's cool.
So you gotta look out for the people.
You do!
You gotta
you
look
do.
Out, and they look out for you.
Well, yeah, like you bringing me on your show after coming on my show.
I've been on your show twice, babe. I love your show.
Yeah.
And never gonna give it up.
Yeah.
Never gonna give it up.
All
this
right
is a morning
now.
Show, so we're just gonna keep
gonna,
right
we,
on.
We're gonna leave it with it. We're gonna keep it locked.
we're gonna lock that up.
Oh my God. But I do wanna say, we talked when I was last on your show, we talked a little bit about the barbs, and I know you get a lot of smoke and a lot of heat from the barbs.
I absolutely hate them.
Are they still on you like that?
I hate them. And here's the deal. Nicki Minaj is complicit. You know, like, if you stand next to somebody who shoots somebody and they die, you're going to jail for murder, too. So I feel like with cyberbullying and so many kids killing themselves these days, you shouldn't stand by while, you know, your terrorist group attacks innocent people. At this point, they've leaked my phone number, Hennessy's phone number, Mariah Lynn's phone number. Cardi's phone number, so yeah, it's really crazy.
The people got hackers on the squad?
No, they just, you know, I think they have friends who have our numbers, and they give the fan pages our numbers, and then they distribute it to everybody.
Yeah.
And you know, when they call, I be the Chinese man, I be the food truck man. It's fun at this point.
Well, do you think that there'll ever be any public resolution between Cardi and Nicki?
You know, I don't really know. I think the one thing I would say about Cardi is she really is who you see is mm-hmm. what you get. She's just a real girl who's out here trying to enjoy her career. And the sad part is, you know, she was a fan of Nicki, so I don't know.
Yes, she was. Well, I'll tell you one thing and two for sure. We have Jason here right here at Sister Circle, and we will be back because we're going to unlock his vault, find out what's really going on. Yes. You don't want to miss it.
And TV personality Jason Lee. Yes. Again.
I just like the slash.
You know what I'm saying?
We talked a little bit about that during the break. You said you could have periods, but instead.
Well, there's a lot of people on Love & Hip Hop with periods after the name.
And sing. Okay, well, let's talk about you being on your second season of Wild & Out.
It's my third season.
Third season? Well, hold it.
Yeah, it's
your third season of Wild & Out.
Give me that third credit.
And, yeah. Do you know
I
what I mean?
Get them checks. I need them checks.
You're already naturally funny, okay?
You see, I'm not a comic. But I just think like really wild, crazy things. And then when I say it, people just are shocked. So I like to just shock people.
So you like the improv and being in front of the audience.
Yeah.
Does it give you a rush or what does it do for
the
you?
The only thing is that the Atlanta audience, they want you to twerk or trap. And I mean, I don't twerk and I don't trap. So I'm doing other crazy stuff.
How do you trap?
I don't
know. Is
that a
dance?
This strip club music. I don't know all of that. I'm an R&B. I like gospel.
Yes.
That ain't wilding out.
Well, look, we want to, really quickly, is there any behind-the-scenes drama that's going on with Wild & Out? Any?
No.
Really
Nick quickly. Cannon runs a really good set.
Come
I mean,
on,
we're over
Nick.
At Tyler Perry
all
Studios
right.
now.
Yes.
I mean,
love
I
that.
Was going around set all day yesterday asking, do you know where Tyler Perry is? I can't find Tyler Perry.
Yeah, you probably won't be able to find them, Jason, I got to tell
rich.
You. But what we can find is what's in your vault. So right now, we're going to talk a little bit about, we're going to give you a list of celebrities,
okay.
and you're going to only have one opportunity to say, lock.
Got it.
Okay, to keep
Let's
that
go.
Person safe. So it's something that no one else knows, okay? First person,
yes.
Floyd Mayweather.
He only wears his underwear and tennis shoes once.
Oh, sanitary, all right, get down.
Rich.
Okay, Cardi B.
I've seen the baby.
Oh.
Baby's cute. I don't have a picture though, so that's kind of it's not locked, but
all right.
I have a mental picture right now in my head. Very, very beautiful baby.
Kim and Kanye.
I'ma lock that one.
You won't lock that
the only
one.
Thing is because I took Cardi over to their house and we had a long, like probably like a 7-hour conversation. And we talked about everything.
Oh, man.
One of those things where Chris made sure to tell me not to put it on Hollywood.
Okay,
Online.
Flower
really
wall.
Quickly, Nicki Minaj.
She's a mean girl.
That's already
well. With that being said, I want to thank you for coming down to the circle.
Yeah, watch out for the bars, okay?
Follow me.
Well, listen, I tell you, you must subscribe right now or download Hollywood Unlocked to see what everything is going on YouTube right now for his podcast or any podcast app, Hollywood Unlocked.
That's right, and you guys know the conversation always continues at Sister Circle TV on all social networks. Yes.